Welcome to the Lumbridge Night Quest Guides for the Cook's Assistant and Sheep Shearer Quests. These are in the Lumbridge area at the start of the game that can be done by characters of any level. All you need is a bucket, a pot, and a pair of shears that can be obtained from the quest. Also look out for a little hidden gem on the video that will save you a lot of time on the Cook's Assistant. It's something I've missed, so keep watching to find out more. Welcome to the Lumbridge Night. Remember to subscribe and like our videos if you don't want to miss out on any of the hints, tips, tricks, and guides that we're going to be bringing you on this channel. So without further ado, let the questing begin. That's a 2-for-1, Cook's Assistant, and the Sheep Shearer quests. These are really basic, so I'm going to try and run through them as fast as possible. As you can see, I've started in Lumbridge, and I've moved straight into the castle, into the kitchen, and spoke to the chef. So, Cook's Assistant is there on the menu, and here we go. He's asking for 3 ingredients. He essentially wants some flour, some milk, and some egg to make a cake for the Duke's birthday. Now, I think it was his birthday anyway. I've initiated the quest. Now off we go. Okay, so here I made a bit of a mistake, so I'm going to cut in. As you can see, my character's slightly different. I'm like a little bit further on in my journey, but I really needed to bring this little tip now. In the video, you're going to see me go right over this bridge. That's heading east up to where the cow field is. Now, pretty much every time I've ever ran through RuneScape, I've always gone to the dairy cows that were sort of northeast of Lumbridge Castle. Now, if you follow where my character's going, I'm going to like razz it through this field. You can actually find all 3 ingredients are literally within a stone's throw of each other. So as long as you've got a bucket and a pot, if you head to sort of where my character, if you follow where he's going now, it's just behind the windmill. You can actually see there is one single dairy cow, which I'm now just about next to. And there I am, I'm going to zoom in. There is the single dairy cow. Now, just before that, you saw that there's a chicken coop and the same place where you get the wheat and you can make the flour. So yeah, use this dairy cow. It is much quicker than going all the way over to the west side of Lumbridge to come all the way back to do the flour, because there is only one mill where you can do the flour at this part of the game. So yeah, this is definitely a worthwhile tip, and something that will save you a couple of minutes, but it makes an easy quest even easier. I'm just going to run to the top of this hill. And there, you can kind of see, there's the windmill, there's the wheat, there's the eggs in that field, and there's the dairy cow, all in one single shot. How easy could you get? Okay, now, I'm going to cut back to the original. Now, at this point, I would say go to the 3rd floor on Lumbridge Castle and put everything in the bank except your bucket and the pot. I haven't done this because I'm playing on an Ironman account, so I can't use the bank, so I've got to kind of do this as a wanner. So forgive me, in this quest it doesn't matter, but in the Sheep Shearer's quest, I'll be adding an extra bit on. So as you can see, you need to head east, directly opposite the castle, head over the bridge east, you're okay because these goblins won't attack you, and head to the cow field that is like directly northeast from the castle courtyard. Now look for the cows that say dairy cow. Don't click on the normal cows, because the first time I did this like an idiot, I was sitting there clicking the bucket and clicking a cow and it wasn't working. You've got to click on the dairy cow, select your bucket, click the cow, bang, I've got the milk, as you can see. Now, if you look over there where my mouse cursor is, you can actually get an egg from there, but because the flower's over here, I'm going to head straight over due west. Follow the path around, past the sheep, past the cows on your right. There isn't any dairy cows in there, so you can't use that area to the right. Now, I'm going to head into here, open the gate, because I can see an egg there. So I'm going to collect that egg, since I've walked past it. There we go, I've selected it. And now if I continue heading west, you can see a wheat field will come into view. So here's just a quick preview, because I should have clicked that earlier. So I'll click on, bloody ran out of run ability, so I'm going to have to walk for a while, so forgive me, I may speed this a little bit up in the video. So find the wheat field, open the gate, pick the wheat, so you can see a wheat sheaf in my inventory now, and head over to the windmill and go inside. Now when I head into the windmill, I'm going to head straight up to the third floor, drop the wheat sheaf into the hopper, and then again stay on the third floor and click the controls. So spin the camera there, you can see the levers sort of in the center there on the opposite side of the hopper. So drop the wheat in the hopper and then use the controls. Again, the first time I did this, I ran downstairs and wondered why my flour wasn't down the bottom. So head down there and use the pot on the flour bin to collect your flour. Now, something worth noting, right, this is a really basic quest, but the first time I did it, because it's, again, rusty, it was a bit confused with another quest where you needed, like, a giant chicken's egg or something, a super large egg, I think it was. So I was there killing chickens for about 20 minutes before I realised this is completely the wrong quest. This is literally flour, milk, egg, done. So I've got it now, and I'm heading back to the castle. But before I do, I'm going to stop off in this little farmhouse. This is Fred's, I think it's Fred the farmer. Yep, there he is, Fred the farmer on the inside. I need to change my graphics because I've not got the roofs on auto hide. And I'm going to click and talk to Fred. I'm going to say I'm looking for a quest. And when you go through the dialogue with Fred, he asks for 20 balls of wool, which means we need to shear the sheep in the field behind us there, go to the castle and use the spinning wheel, and then bring him the balls of wool back. Now, you will be able to do this if you've took my advice and put the non-essential items in the bank. You'll be able to do this in one run. You'll be able to get 20 fleeces from the sheep, and then go to the castle, turn them into 20 balls of wool, hand in the cook's assistant, and then hand in the balls of wool, and that will end these two quests, and you'll get your rewards. As it is, I'll have to make two runs to hand in this last quest, because I'm using an Ultimate Ironman account, so I can't use the bank. So I'm dropping and getting rid of some items that I don't really need for now, to try and clear space so I can do it in two runs. And then I'm going to use the style. As I mentioned in my previous video, you can see I've got a weird kind of green outline. That's because I'm using the Rune Light client. And it just adds a little bit, some extra tools and some nice plugins that I'm trying out to just see if it adds anything to the video or adds anything to the gameplay. So far so good, I recommend giving it a go. It definitely offers extra customization, which I quite like, but there's a lot of settings to play with. So for the moment, I'm just using the sort of vanilla things with a few advice videos I've watched, which I'll share on the channel. I'll also put a link to Rune Light in the description. So yeah, as I say, I'm running around, I'm collecting wool from the sheep. Now if you notice, there's some rams, the ones with the horns, obviously, you can't get anything off them. And there's also a thing in the field, which is two penguins with a... There you can see it sort of at the bottom right-hand side of the screen now. It kind of sidles along, doesn't look quite as natural as the other sheep. I think I do try to get a fleece off it at some point. Okay, so now my inventory's full. I'm going to head back to the castle. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to walk a lot of it because my running energy has run out. But I'll use whatever 29 points of it to try and get to the handing point as fast as possible. So off we go. And I've finally realised there's a problem. So I'm going to go up my settings and I'm going to auto-hide the roof because it's really... I'm going to put my chat box on transparent and auto-hide the roofs because it's really inconvenient. There we go, hide roofs, click it off. It's really inconvenient to have it on. It just means it's hard to click on things and also hard to see things coming, so it's much better to have it on this view. And now if we click on the, this is the cook's assistant. I've got all three of the items he was after. So if I click on the cook, here we go. I've got a bucket of milk, a pot of flour, and a fresh egg. Boom. Can I go to the juice party? Hell no. Good. But that is the end of the quest. So we get 300 cooking XP and one quest point. Brilliant. So we'll take that. There we go. That took my cooking from level 1 to level 4 in one fell swoop. And now as I'm already in the castle, I'm going to head upstairs and use the spinning wheel. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to walk again because I don't have much stuff. Don't have much energy. So here we go, click on there, and it's in this bedroom here. You can see the spinning wheel there. Just click on it, and it's already automatically set to all. So I've selected balls of wool, and now I'll just automatically craft the fleeces into wool, balls of wool. So just give that a couple of seconds to kind of finish off. Doesn't take long at all. Obviously, these are also gaining crafting experience doing this. So if you wanted to craft, you can shear sheep and turn it into wool and probably sell the wool. It's probably not the best way of making money or getting crafting experience, but if that's what you want to do, you can do it. In up and coming videos, because obviously I'm going to have to level this character up, I'll bring you some training videos about the best spots kind of at the start of the game on free in and around Lumbridge that are good to kind of grind out the combat score. I tend to spend a lot of the game at the start fighting just the goblins in and around Lumbridge because they're quite easy to kill, they're not that dangerous, and you can get some bronze items. Obviously bronze is not very good and it's not worth a huge amount of money, but early on in the game, every little helps, it's useful. Now as you can see, I don't have enough inventory space to get the full 20, so I'm going to use the gate sidle, head over, and I'm going to hand in the, how many have I got, 8, 9, 10, the 11 balls of wool I've got, I'm going to hand in to Fred right now. So here we go, talk to Fred. What are you doing on my land? He's forgotten he's given me a quest. Click through. I've got the balls of wool. So there we go. Head back where I came from. Like, again, I might speed the video up, so you might be watching like a sped up run because the walking speed really is horrendous on this game. And I'm going to start shearing some sheep, so I need to get 9 more. Just go around looking for the sheep. There's the thing, I've selected the thing. Heading back up to the first floor of the castle to use the spinning wheel and spin these final 9 balls of wool. Here we go. It's already on all. Select the balls of wool, and now my character will just do that for me. Toying with the idea of making like some pure accounts, like some PK accounts, Black Pures, Mithril Pures, Addy Pures, Rune Pures. You know, there was a day when, you know, you used to get yourself a full black armor, a Rune Two-Hander, and you would just put everything into strength, and that was like your PK of choice. Obviously, when they rebalanced the magic and the range, it kind of changed things a bit. So I mean, if people want to see a PK in series, or they've got any ideas of kind of the kind of characters they want to see, or if anything worked, if they've got any questions, you know, give us a shout and I'm happy to sort of bring you that kind of stuff. Okay, I'm going to tell Fred a sort of thing, just so you guys can see the dialogue. He overreacts about some sort of doom monster, and then we say it's some sort of penguin in suits, and he says, "You've been out in the sun too long." I'll restart, and this time I'll tell him, remind him about the quest, and hopefully hand him these balls of wool. Here we go. I've miscounted and had one extra for some reason. Boom. End of the quest. So I've got 3 pair of shears. Oh no, it's took it now. So there we go. And 150 crafting experience plus 60 coins. So that's jumped my crafting to level 3. And I can now craft polished buttons. Joy. So that kind of brings me to the end of the video. Look out for any future quests. Please, if you like the video, drop us a like, subscribe, and please join in, give me any suggestions you want for future content. Peace out, guys.